Translation. This cosmic manifestation, the material world, is also your body, by your potential energy known as Kala Shakti. This total lump of matter becomes agitated, and thus three modes of material nature become manifested. In this way you become awakened from the bedstead of Anantasesha, and from your navel a small transcendental seed is generated, from which the gigantic universe becomes manifest, exactly like the small seed of banyan tree. The lotus flower of the cosmic manifestation is grown up.
This verses of Srimad Bhagavatam, they are Vedic mantras. They are ordinary wording, set of wording. It is not. Veda mantra, Sanghita. So every one of you must try to chant. This is required. Each verse of Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam, they are Vedic mantras, Veda mantra. So simply by chanting them, we become purified. So every one of you, there is diacritic marks, literation, transliteration. So everyone should try to chant the mantra. That is very beneficial. That is kirtan. Kirtanadeva krishnasya. Everything is being chanted in relationship with Krishna, with reference to Krishna. So this material world is explained. Tasyaivate babhuridam nijakala shaktya sanchodita prakriti dharma manaj atma gudam ambasi ammasi anantya sayanad viramat samadhi nabhi abhut sakanika batavat mahabjam. Batavat mahabjam. Abjam means flower, lotus flower. Yes. So this is the description of Garbhodakshai Vishnu. Karanadakshai Vishnu, and then Garbhodakshai Vishnu, and then Kshirodakshai Vishnu. Three Vishnu. First of all, from I have several times explained, from Krishna, then expansion, Balaram, then Chaturbhuha, Sankarsan, Pradyumna, Niruddha, like that. Then Narayan, then Ditya Chaturbhuha, from Ditya Chaturbhuha, Vaikuntha, Sankarsan, then Purusha, Purushavata, these Purushas and three. In the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna recognize Krishna as Purusha. Purusham Sasatam Adyam. So is the Purusha. God is Purusha, male. God is not female. Female, the Shakti, that is female, Prakriti. In the Bhagavad Gita also it is mentioned, Prakriti me astadha, bhinna Prakriti me astadha. This material nature is separated energy. divided into 8 elements, earth, water, air, and fire, then ether, mind, intelligence, and ego. These are all prakriti, material. Bhinna me prakriti astadha. Bhinna. Bhinna means separated. There is not direct connection. But another prakriti, there is aparayam itastu vidhi me prakriti para. This is inferior energy, material, elements, and there is superior element, prakriti. That is also prakriti. We are prakriti. Prakriti means under the control of the purusha. That is nature. We cannot conceive equal rights of purusha and prakriti. That is not Vedic conception. Vedic conception is purusha, the superior, supreme, and prakriti means subordinate. Purusha is predominator and prakriti is predominated. So, we living entities, we are prakriti. Falsely, if we try to become purusha, that is maya. We should remain prakriti, subservient, predominator. That is this Krishna consciousness movement. Because generally the people are misled, thinking himself as purusha and the enjoyer. But that is not the fact. That false ego, that I am enjoyer, that is false ego. And real ego is I am servant of Krishna. So there is no necessity of giving up egotism or egoism, but it must be real. At the present moment, you are falsely thinking, I am this body. Every one of us, there is no argument. The whole material world is going on the basis of this false conception that I am this body. And because I am this body, therefore I am American, I am Indian. So this is false ego. So from this false ego, when we come to real ego, what is that real ego? That I am servant of Krishna. Gopi bhattu pada kamalu dasa dasa dasanu dasa. That is real ego. So our, this Krishna consciousness movement is teaching people how to come to the real ego, real constitution position. The Mayavadi philosophy, they are also trying to do that, but they are another false ego. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi, I am Brahma. That is a fact. But I am not Supreme Brahma, Parabrahma. The Mayavadi, they take it, because I am Brahma, I am Supreme. No. Suppose you are all coming from America, you can claim that you are American. But that does not mean you are Mr. Ford, the president. Similarly, this is false ego. If somebody thinks, because I am American, therefore I am equal to Mr. Ford, that is false. That is not. So our Krishna consciousness movement is how to bring back this, I want to say, insane, crazy fellows to their real consciousness. This crazy fellow, they are thinking, I am God, I am master, I am this, I am that, I am prime minister, I am president. This is false. The real ego is, I am servant of Krishna. That is the beginning of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teaching. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was approached by Sanatana Goswami, his first question was, Kiyami? Who am I? This is the first education, spiritual education. And the same thing is taught in the Bhagavad Gita. Because Arjuna was too much identifying himself, the bodily conception of life, I belong to this guru's family, so if I kill them, then family will be ruined, the women will be widows, and they will be corrupted, then there will be unwanted children, varnasankar, and in this way the whole world will be hellish, and so on, so on. But beginning with the bodily conception of life. All what was Arjuna was explaining to Krishna, that was, from material point of view, it is very nice. He wanted to become non-violent. He did not like to kill his family members. He rather liked to forego his claim. I don't want. Let them enjoy. But everything, from a material point of view, it was very nice proposal. But this identification with family, with nation, with community, these are all foolishness. All foolishness. So if you study this point only, you'll see the whole world is full of fools and dusters. Because everyone is identifying with his body. There is fight. The United Nations, what is this United Nations nonsense? Assembly of rascals and fools. Because they have got this bodily concept of life, we can say freely. There is no, what is it called? Defaming. Everyone, fools and rascals. How we can say, on the strength of Vedic knowledge, this is our power. Otherwise, how we can challenge the United Nations that you are all assembly of fools and rascals? This is Vedic knowledge. We can say and prove it that they are all fools and rascals. From the spiritual point of view, because they do not know their identification. This is the first education, to know one's identification. That is being taught by Sanatana Goswami and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was prime minister, he knew himself, Sanatana Goswami, that he was prime minister of Husain Shah, and he's coming of very learned Brahmin family, he knew it. Then why he is asking, Kiyami, who I am? This is knowledge. This is knowledge. One has to understand himself. That is the basic principle of spiritual life. Unless we understand who I am, you go to the spiritual master, our first business is inquiry. That inquiry is, who am I? This is it. That is the beginning of inquiry. So, our this Krishna consciousness movement is authorized. We have printed one pamphlet. Krishna consciousness movement is authorized It is not a sentiment fanaticism. No, it is scientific authorized. I am very glad that you, European, American boys, have taken so much trouble to come here. But you'll be benefited if you come here and try to take lessons from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as he gave it to Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami inquired, "Who am I?" And he replied very simple thing, "Jiver Sarupai Nitya Krishna Das." This is the beginning of a lesson. So you must understand very nicely this mind. So this material world is explained here. Tasyavati Bapuridam Nijakala Shaktya. Energy. Krishna's energy. Prakriti. Energy means prakriti. Parasya Brahmana Shakti. Ekasthani Sitasagne. Jyotsna Vistarina Jatha. Parasya Brahmana Shakti Tathaiva Akhilam Jagat. Then same thing we'll find in the Vedic literature everywhere. Either you read Puranas or Mahabharata or Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam or Vedanta Sutra. Vedanta Sutra also says there is origin, absolute truth is origin, and everything is emanation. So emanation and the original path, Bhapuridam. Idam Visham Bhagavan Ibhitar. This Visham, this universe, is Bhagavan in one sense. Just like this my finger. So that is also my body. Although it is named finger, but it is my body. Or even a piece of hair. That is also my body. Although it is differently named here. Similarly, when you understand that every particle of this material world is also the body of the Supreme Lord, that is Krishna consciousness. Annantarasam paramanuchayantarasam ekappasaurachayatam jagadannakoti. So there are millions and trillions of universes, and each atom of each universe is Krishna. That we have to understand. That is being explained here. Tasyavati babhuridam nijakala satya sanchodita prakriti dharma nayatvapu. Guram. The secret the people they do not know. But Prahlad Maharaj knows. Ambhosi, this is the beginning of creation. Ambhosi. Ambhosi Ananta Sayana. Ananta there. The Ananta faces there are only that. Ananta Nag, the Gadbhoduk Sai Vishnu is lying on. So, from the level of Gadbhoduk Sai Vishnu, there is a lotus flower, Bhatavat Mahabjam. So there is Brahma, and Brahma created other things. So it is just like in the previous verse it has been explained. Just like the seed and the fruit or the tree. Seed is the cause of the tree, and tree is the cause of the seed. In this way, the whole material, mass cosmic manifestation is there, and Bhapuridam, Tava, Te, everything of Krishna. Therefore, a Vaishnava, conception is that everything, at least Krishna's, so everything should be utilized for Krishna's benefit. This is Krishna consciousness, not my benefit. I also belong to Krishna. I must utilize for Krishna's benefit. In this way, if we develop our Krishna consciousness, then we will be benefited. Thank you very much.